started out with the Bishop Capa Seymour Memorial Photographic Foundation, founded in 1966. Its first exhibition was called The Concerned Photography in 1967 at the Riverside Museum in New York, at which point we changed the name of the fund to the International Fund for Concerned Photography. And in 1974, when we bought the building on 94th Street and 5th Avenue, it was called the International Center of Photography. It's all under one roof now. Since then, 3 years are behind us. We have mounted about 61 exhibitions of all sizes, major, minor, smaller, larger. We have had 80 lectures of photographers. We had about 50 lectures of, as others see us, editors, curators, people who deal with photographs but don't take them. We have had 40 or 50 symposia on different problems that photography is involved with and problems of photography itself. And we have had almost uncountable workshops and teaching programs. We have been able to present a great number of photographers from different countries because they hit New York and we made them hit New York. As such, the international aspects of this particular institution is unique because it can only happen in New York.
Okay, I think I should begin by saying that this is our seventh semester and it has grown enormously, whereas we started out with maybe the first, I would say, 100 students. We've now grown to over 600 students.
Okay, Pamela, can you give me a sense of the background in what you had in photography?
Easily, because there's not much. I took a course, an elementary darkroom course at the Visual Arts School this fall. Mm-hmm. Prior to that, I had never taken any photographs.
Now, you want to go on in photography?
Yes.
To what end?
I would like to do it. I write. Mm-hmm. So subsequently, I'm interested in, I guess, what you would label photojournalism. I would like to put together, I write poetry primarily. My end would be to write, to photograph, and complement the photographs with my work.
Is it in terms of a book form?
Yes, a book.
Mm-hmm. Okay, but I think the only course, let me see the program.
Yes, I do.
Okay. So were you thinking of an introductory too?
Yes, an introductory too, because I think, I certainly feel that I've learned enough. Mm-hmm. Maybe you won't think so after you see my photographs, but...
Initially, we had thought that we would have workshops for more advanced photographers. This would incorporate sort of the semi-amateur photographer to the professional. But in fact, what happened was, with the debut of photography as a major art form, quote-unquote, interest in photography just became incredible, so that we really had to sort of cater and respond to the community at large, so that we now have classes that begin from the very basic introductory class to advanced weekend workshops.
Now let's say we have something very black. I'll call this black. And I'll call this white, right? Very small. Now we'll go with this white, black, and white. These are very small objects and you really can't get close enough. Did I do this again? You take the gray card, right? And you hold it up there. Now you take the gray card out. Let's say the exposure was F8 at a 30th. What happens if you expose it F8 at a 30th?
You'd have two gray objects.
No, you would not. You'd have the right exposure.
We are very much interested, mostly, primarily interested, in the documentary nature of photography. the institution itself is very much involved in the concerns of photographers and photography, which is us today.
Unique? Well, I mean, my suspicions are the intimacy, for one thing, the fact that the classes are so small, the fact that we really have a hell of a good faculty. You know, you have to think of what the audience is that comes to ICP. Obviously, the ones who come for exhibitions may have only a peripheral interest in photography. Those who are involved in the educational program are those who want to be more intimately involved. The best relationship is when you have someone who's involved in the center, not only through the education. There are many other ways you can get involved on a voluntary basis. If someone really is good in terms of their own technical ability, they might assist us. In exchange, they would get a workshop. What we realized, too, that this could be a marvelous source of energies from other disciplines. We really wanted to attract degree students. So we went out for accreditation last fall, and we got accreditation. That means that more and more we're going to be getting graduate students.
All our interns who are spending a year with us during a year's time get introduced to the work of over 20 photographers through lectures, 100 photographers and editors and curators through discussions, and about 30 to 35 photographic exhibitions as their backdrop. Speaking of that, and about 55, 60, 70 workshop and teaching courses, they are really having an apprenticeship in photography which cannot be matched presently and could not be matched through the normal apprenticeship system of previous generations. Photography is 150 years old. It's accepted as a language, and we don't know what the language says. We want photography to be learned, explained, and we're trying to learn people to use it in an intelligent manner. It's a most important, most contemporary communication and art forms, and we want to introduce that, the knowledge of that, to all generations.
I guess my hope would be, in terms of the center, that we get more and more serious photographers who are not just photographers, but who have the ability to work in other disciplines, who can be photographers if they want to be photographers, if they can be artists, if they want to be artists. But if they want to marry photography and anthropology, or marry sociology and photography, or marry aesthetics, I think that's the beauty of ICP, that it is, as I've said before, amorphic and very open.
As a result of the 7 days and seven nights activity here, and as a result of showing the world of photography here, this became not a museum, but the home for photographers and the home for photography. And that's what we want to keep, that's what we want to develop, and that's what the significance of ICP is going to be, that.